Good morning, guys. Last night, while you were sleeping, there was a magnitude 3.4 earthquake near Petrolia, California. It occurred at 3:40 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So far, two people have reportedly sent in reports that they felt this earthquake. This was a thrust earthquake, and so far, USGS doesn't have an impact for how far the fault probably ruptured. This is where you got one side of the fault rising up over another fault. Thrust earthquakes are the most dangerous earthquakes, especially if they happen out in the ocean. They can create tsunamis. But this earthquake was on land. It could have caused rock slides, landslides within that area. And as you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for a much larger earthquake. This area is capable of having a magnitude 8 or greater earthquake. Back in 1992, what they're calling the Mendocino earthquakes, there was a magnitude 7.2. That earthquake occurred on April 25th, 1992, about 30 miles southeast of Eureka. It triggered landslides and rock falls, and 95 people were injured. That earthquake was so powerful that it pushed the shore, the coast, up 4 feet. Homes moved from their foundations, chimneys fell, and aftershocks sparked an electrical fire that engulfed the lone shopping center in the town of Scotia. Water lines broke, so they had no water going to the fire hydrants to put out the fires that happened because of the aftershocks. According to CEA, California Earthquake Authority, there is a 76% likelihood of one or more 7 point or larger, like I said, you could have a magnitude 8 earthquake striking in this area. The Cascadia subduction zone stretches underneath the Humboldt del Norte County region, extending from Cape Mendocino all the way through the Pacific Northwest. Now, according to them, this zone is capable of generating an earthquake of a magnitude 9 or larger. On average, but everything doesn't always go by averages, they have them once every 500 years, and the last event was in 1700. So it's been about 321 years since that great earthquake in 1700. Now, the southern half of the Cascadia subduction zone, where today's earthquake occurred. Historically, generally, earthquakes, they have them up to a magnitude 8 or greater. So far, the two reports of feeling this magnitude 3.4 earthquake came from Whitehorn. USGS gave it an intensity level of 2, which means, according to the modified mercantile scale, it is only felt by a few peoples when they're resting. Well, they were probably in bed, especially on upper floors of buildings. Delicate suspended objects may swing. Some of the monitors picked up the shaking right away, especially there in Petrolia. But other areas, they actually recorded the shaking lasting up to 10 seconds. And there was other monitors that picked up the shaking for, probably a minute. But it was probably so weak that most people didn't even feel it for that long. But that's quite a long shake, and it's not surprising seeing how it was a thrust earthquake. I would be real curious on the distance of the fault rupture. But that information they don't have posted yet. So did you feel this earthquake? Were your animals acting up prior to it? And how did they react if you even noticed it? Afterwards. And for those that did feel it, what did the motion feel like? Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your support. I really appreciate it. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all.